448.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be his kingdom now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan didst proclaim him thy beloved Son and anoint him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with thee and the same Spirit liveth and reigneth, one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
A reading from Acts. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the interior regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." Then he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" They answered, "Into John's baptism." Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, you gods, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord splits the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees writhe and strips the forests bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying, glory! The Lord sits enthroned above the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forevermore. The Lord shall give strength to his people. The Lord shall give his people the blessing of peace.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. John proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus from Nazareth of Galilee came and was baptized by John in the River Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning, the Gospel lesson, we have a tale, not of two cities, but a tale of two baptisms. The first baptism is the baptism of John in the River Jordan, and the second one is Jesus actually being baptized in the River Jordan by John. So what's the difference between those two? Because they seem to be described as two different types of baptisms. Well, John's baptism was one of change, of repentance. In other words, make good choices, but it's a matter of me changing, me doing something, me responding. And what usually turns out is that becomes a baptism of, well, I'm baptized, it's good, I'll be a nice person from now on. And it's kind of really an exercise in saving ourselves. And God's not really a part of all that other than we're trying to be really, really, really good for God. So John's baptism is about my effort. And it's supposed to bear fruit in something bigger. In other words, I need to attach it to Jesus' baptism in order to bring it to its full potential. Because just by myself, trying to save myself by trying to be a good person, I fail miserably, all in all. And I know the truth of the matter is you do too. And so John's baptism, my willingness to repent, to turn, and to reorient myself towards God, is prep work for something bigger. And that something bigger is baptism by Jesus, by the Holy Spirit. That's one where I am changed. You see, the first baptism of John, I orient myself towards God. In the second one, I fill myself with God, or maybe with Jesus, or with the Holy Spirit, as Jesus received the Holy Spirit in this piece of scripture. And so often the point of baptism goes over our head, because we think baptism as an event rather than a lifestyle. And so we think the magic comes by the event. In other words, well, I was baptized, therefore my child, or I am fireproofed, or something wonderful, or it's like fairy dust, or a rabbit's foot. And that's the baptism of John. It has to be completed by the baptism of Jesus, or the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And so the magic happens only in the context of an ongoing relationship with a living and loving God. Because when I'm in relationship with God, then I can take my orientation that I have done, and I have to continue to do every day, and direct it towards God and ask God to fill me with the Spirit, which then brings me to fully being human and fully engaged in God and fully becoming an agent of the good news of Jesus Christ. So it boils down to this. Do I want simply willpower, or do I want the power of God? Do I want to be able to do the best I can, or do I want to be able to be part of the best that God has to offer? And do I want a baptism that's backed by the power of me, the power of Jim, or a baptism that's backed by the power of God? So baptism, is it an event or is it a lifestyle? If it's an event, it's sort of like John's, and it's basically depends on me. But if it's a lifestyle, then I have to orient myself toward God with a baptism like John's, but then I have to complete it by allowing God to go through me. And I can only have God go through me when I have a relationship with God. I can't just have a tip of the hat to God. It becomes a lifestyle. So much of that lifestyle depends on how we view or engage God and the people around us. So I want to kind of talk about a couple of things that we use to sort of understand God that maybe aren't helpful. God sort of is a gas station. You know, fill her up when we need it, maybe top her off if I need to. But either way, I got to go. I'm in a hurry. And so we don't really engage God. We just know God's out there to fill us up when we need it. Well, that's not going to bring our baptism to its fullest potential. Or we see God as a doctor who we have on retainer, but we pay little attention to, or really not really sure we want to pay attention to. Hope we'll never need, but expect to sort of bail us out in the end. And again, if God is like a doctor who's going to bail us out when things get really, really bad, then we're going to miss the goodies that God has to offer. And that is goodies in the sense of it's eternal life. It's life everlasting. It's resurrection. It's the ability for us to make a difference in the world around us, which in the end makes a difference in us. Or sometimes we treat God like gravity. Doesn't really interest me. I forget about it most days. I try not to defy it. But I expect it will let me bounce back. Again, you notice there's a theme to these things is that God and the way we treat other people is very utilitarian. In other words, you're here, God, in my life for your usefulness rather than because I love you and I earnestly need you. Or maybe God, who's a vending machine, I pay the price, I pray just perfectly, and then I get what I want when I need it. Or maybe God is the tailgate guy, supplies all the best, does all the works. All we got to do is show up. I mean, yeah, of course, all of us want that kind of easy relationship. But as Jesus says, you strive to enter through the narrow door. Evidently, the wide door doesn't lead where we really want to go. But this takes work. And this takes us willing to develop that relationship with God. We want the baptism of John, like every time I did, oh yeah, I'm going to try to be a good person. I'm going to try to be a good person. I'm going to try to be a good person. It doesn't last very long. But God says, no, what I really want is I want you to infuse yourself with the Spirit, the same Spirit that Jesus infused himself with, and then you become a different person. You transcend the world around you. You bring life to other people, and you bring life to yourself. And then sometimes we just want to reduce God to something manageable, sort of like trying to fold a fitted sheet. We just wad it up and put it aside. And maybe we just sort of give up on having a relationship. But see, we do all these things with other people too. We make them very utilitarian, or we only use them when we need them. And we don't develop those relationships. And part of the pain that our country goes through right now is because we are not willing to not only not develop the relationship with God, but not develop the relationship with each other. Because all of our God relationships should be reflected in our human relationships. And relationships are not easy. But the payoff is huge. It's going to be hard, but the results are going to be great. And most of us want instant microwave results. So we can't view people as a utility. So some way to maybe work our spiritual life is maybe we start with people and realize, how do I treat other people? And I don't really move into a relationship, but I treat them more for utilitarian purposes, and maybe that'll help reflect in our spiritual life. Or maybe we start in our spiritual life with God, and then it'll reflect in the lives of the world around us. You can't detach those two. You know, as Jesus says, you can't hate your neighbor and love God. Those two, they go together. But there's no doubt about this. God wants us to have life and have it in abundance, and it starts with a change of heart. That's me. But it ends in a relationship with God where God infuses me with God's Spirit. You need both. So we have a choice every day. Which baptism are we going to invest in? The baptism of we're sprinkled, dipped, and sent on our way, or dunked maybe, and sent on our way, and we sort of save ourselves, or the one that has a lasting impact on our lives and has a lasting impact on the lives around us. And it doesn't depend upon us manipulating the circumstances in our favor, which we can't do. But it's rooted in how we're going to view God and how we're going to view one another. So will we engage not just simply in the baptism of John, but in the messy work of relating to God, and as we say in our baptismal vows, and to all persons? Ultimately, baptism is a lifestyle, and it's a lifestyle of listening, and it's a lifestyle of presence, and not simply an act of saying, I'm sorry, or even an act of saying, look, I'm going to change my ways. That's the baptism of John. Relationships or relating to God and to each other is the baptism of Jesus. We will transcend the world around us, and we will become more fully alive. It is work, and it is worth it. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have seen the light of Christ and for all who work to spread that light in the world, may they have the joy that moves mountains and the peace that wins over all enemies. We pray especially for Christians whose faith must withstand the loss of home, family, and personal safety. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For the leaders of Christian communities around the world, may their wisdom and gentleness inspire the faithful and convert the hard-hearted. We pray for those who lead the Anglican Communion and our own church. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For those who lead the nations of the world and for all countries and people, may they do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly as servants of the kingdom of God, and for all those who work for peace and reconciliation. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For the needs of our own community, for our neighbors, and for those whose dignity depends on our compassion, in helping and being helped, may we bring out the holiness in one another. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. For all who have lost home and security through war, natural disaster, and economic hardship, may we have the courage and energy to see and respond to their needs, and may they find the safe rest that is a foretaste of our promised rest in heaven. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for Deepa, Alicia and family, Betty, Jay, Jason and family, Harry and family, victims of hate crimes, those who are hungry, and all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. May they find healing and strength. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for the engagement of Ben Nye to Alyssa Chotis, the engagement of Justin Cole to Sarah Beth Krimger, Christopher Nye becoming an Eagle Scout, and all the blessings of this life. For Ryan Harland, Caitlin Berry, Julia Roll, Kapila Jayensa, Irene Taylor, Doran Miller, Kara Berry, and Logan Thornton, who are celebrating birthdays this week. And for Yadira Estrada and Jenny Flores, and Don and Gay Strickland, who are celebrating anniversaries this week. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for our partners in mission. May they join with us in spreading the gospel and building the kingdom. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for all who have died. We give thanks for all the saints and faithful people who have gone before us. May they have rest from their labors and a share in God's promises. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in thy will and walk in thy ways to the glory of thy name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. The peace of the Lord be always with you and with thy spirit.
To England or France. You may like to gamble, you might like to dance. You may be the heavyweight champion of the world. You might be a socialite with a long string of pearls, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, indeed, you're gonna have to serve somebody. Well, it may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Might be a rock and roll addict prancing on the stage. You might have drugs at your command, women in a cage. You may be a businessman or some high degree thief. They may call you doctor, or they may call you chief, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, indeed, you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Well, it may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Might be a state trooper, you might be a young Turk. You might be the head of some big TV network. You may be rich or poor, you may be blind or lame, maybe living in another country under another name, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, indeed, you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Well, it may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Be a construction worker working on a home. Maybe living in a mansion, might be living in a dome. You might own guns, you might even own tanks. Might be somebody's landlord, you might even own banks, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, you are, you're gonna have to serve somebody. Or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
You may be a preacher with your spiritual pride. You may be a city councilman taking bribes on the side. You may be working in a barbershop, you might know how to cut hair. Maybe somebody's mistress, maybe somebody's heir, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Well, it may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Might like to wear cotton, might like to wear silk, might like to drink whiskey, might like to drink milk, might like to eat caviar, might like to eat bread, maybe sleep. sleeping on the floor, sleeping in a king-size bed, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, indeed, you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Well, it may be the devil, or it may be the Lord, but you're gonna have to serve somebody. You may call me Steve, you may call me Shape, you may call me out, you may call me safe. You may call me young man, you may call me gray, you may call me anything, it doesn't matter what you say, you're still gonna have to serve somebody. Yes, you're gonna have to serve somebody. Well, it may be the devil, but I pray that it's the Lord, cause you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, fill your hearts and minds with the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon you now and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.